Okay, Trini, we are in for a treat today. If you don't have your morning coffee, don't worry, because our friends at McDonald's Restaurants of Hawaii have got us covered.
Yes, they do. Now, you've seen our McCafe mugs on set every morning, and I'm sure their coffee has become part of your morning routine, too. But have you ever wondered how McDonald's of Hawaii's coffee is produced? We are learning about that today. Take a look. This is where it happens, folks. We are here at Hawaii Coffee Company. We're here to learn how McDonald's of Hawaii's coffee is produced.
Yeah, it's delicious. I've already drank half my prop this morning, but we're joined by Melanie Okazaki. And Melanie, you know, McDonald's has all these great partnerships with local companies, but this one with Hawaii Coffee Company goes way, way back, right?
It does. Ever since we came here to Hawaii back in 1968, McDonald's of Aina Hina.
First one.
Yes, Hawaii Coffee Company has been our very valuable partner.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome.
Tell us about the different products that you guys have.
Yes, Hawaii Coffee Company provides our Royal Kona blend, and this is something that you can only get here in Hawaii. You can go to McDonald's across the globe.
Anywhere in the world.
Anywhere, but this is the only place where you can get that special Royal Kona blend.
In fact, you were in Japan recently, and you said their coffee tasted differently than
Very
the one
different.
Here.
I must say, it's good coffee, but it's not the best coffee. When I came back home, one of the first places I went to was a black coffee right at McDonald's by Nimitz.
You know, the flavor is very distinct.
Yeah.
It's very flavorful. There's this bold kind of taste to
underlying taste. It's so good. So good.
So you're having, because you have hot, but you also have cold.
Yep.
You have it iced, too.
Right. And then we also serve it in our specialty brand with McCafe.
Oh.
And then also, too, our green tea, our hot green tea, as well as our tropical iced tea blend. It all comes from Hawaii Coffee Company.
Well, can we learn a little bit more about this?
Yes. We're going to get a behind-the-scenes tour.
Right.
Let's go. Here we are in the lab. We've got our hairnets on. We are ready for our tour. Now, we are with Dan Danell with Hawaii Coffee Company.
Yeah, Dan, tell us how one of these little coffee beans or a bunch of his friends go all through the process and end up in this great-tasting coffee.
Sure. It starts with green beans. You roast it, pack it. We ship it out to all the stores, including McDonald's restaurants, and it turns into that wonderful cup of coffee.
You make it sound so easy.
Yeah.
Well, tell us what happens in this room.
Yeah,
what happens here? It all starts here. This is our lab, so we do our quality control here. We do cuppings, tasting, to make sure that that cup of coffee is what the customer wants.
Yeah, Trini, there's more medical and science equipment here than anything I've ever seen. There's a spectrometer, an analyzer. I mean, you really look into the color and the fine quality of the bean before you even send it out, right?
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so from here, tell us about the next room.
Yeah, what was the next?
Sure, we'll see a mountain of green beans here. Green beans come from all over the world, and of course, here at Hawaii Coffee Company, we're the world's largest roaster of Kona coffee. We do blends, and that's what we do here in the green bean setup area.
Forgive me for asking a naive question, but so what happens? You take the bean from the field, and then you got to roast it. What is exactly roasting? What is that?
Well, as you can see right here in our big roasters, you put the green beans in, they roast about 10 minutes up to 420 degrees, and different roast levels will have different taste profiles.
Okay. So you can actually change the way and alter the taste of the bean in the coffee.
Absolutely. Light roast brings out, accents most of the flavors, medium roast, and then a dark roast will really be like your espressos and the like.
When it comes to Kona coffee, temperature-wise, how long do you keep that in there? How long does the process go for that one?
Well, it's very similar to any other Arabica coffee beans that we roast here. So we just find the very best coffees from around the world, including the Kona Coast, and make blends that people love.
Right.
Okay, what's next after the roasting room?
So after roasting, as you can see here, we will grind it. We'll also, some of our coffees are flavored coffees, and ultimately, it gets packed into these bags. Some are going to restaurants, hotels, others are going to retail shops. You can see one of the most important things in packaging is to expel the oxygen out of the bag, because once you roast the coffee, the oxygen will actually make it grow stale over time. And so that's why when you open a bag of coffee that's been packed well, you smell that roasted coffee, because we inject nitrogen, which expels the oxygen out of a one-way valve and makes that wonderful roasted coffee.
Well, I wish we had smell-o-vision, because as soon as you walk in the building, you can smell coffee. It smells so delicious.
I want it to be my new cologne. I'm serious. Like, I love the smell of coffee. This is such a great place.
We believe you. Thank you so much. This is so interesting.
Well, our pleasure. And come back to the Willy Wonka Coffee Factory, and we'll have smell-o-vision done.
Absolutely. And don't forget McDonald's of Hawaii, where you can get that special coffee.
Only in McDonald's Hawaii. And real quickly, though, you guys are available for tours if people want to come down here and check it out, too.
Absolutely. Monday through Thursday, 10:30 and 1 p.m. We have public tours, and we really invite your viewers to come down and smell and taste the coffee.
All right, Dan, thank you. I'm so happy that we had a chance to check that out, because I've been in that area all the time, and I never knew that they were located there.
Right there.
I never knew you could get a tour there.
Yes, right off White Camilla Street in the Kalihi area. We have links on our website. But it's so cool that McDonald's Hawaii, you know, partnering with local producers like that. I mean, that's local-grown coffee from our islands in our cup every morning. That's so cool. It's great for business.
So I had my daughter with me that
day when we were there.
And it was so interesting even for her to see how things are put together.
Isn't it? How they roast it, the whole process go through. Also, they have a gift shop. If you're ever looking for gift baskets, that's the place to go, trust me. But really good. I had a hard time leaving, and I've had about 3-4 cups of coffee when
I
was there.
You did have a lot of coffee.
I was bouncing
that
off
day.
The ceiling.
Yes, he was.
It was like Christmas and New Year's all in one place. But again, mahalo to McDonald's Hawaii and Hawaii Coffee Company.
All right.